फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू बिग फूडीज। टुडे वी आर मेकिंग अरबी के पत्ते, ऑल्सो नोन बाय वेरियस नेम्स ग्लोबली एज कोलोकेशिया लीव्स और टारो रूट लीव्स और एलिफेंट ईयर्स लीव्स, एंड इन इंडिया एज पत्रा इन गुजराती, आलू वड़ी इन मराठी और पेथ्रोद लीव्स इन कर्नाटका। दिस इज अ क्विक एंड हेल्दी रेसिपी वेयर द स्टीम्ड वड़ीज आर स्पाइस्ड बाय टेम्परिंग इंस्टेड ऑफ डीप फ्राइंग देम। Traditionally, the leaves are stuffed with chickpea batter, but this recipe uses protein-rich lentils to make the batter, which makes it a protein-packed and tasty snack as well as a side dish. It has a beautiful texture and taste. Friends, if you like this recipe, then please take a moment to subscribe to Big Foodies by pressing the subscribe button to get more delicious recipes and never miss a video from Big Foodies. And it is completely free. And hit the bell icon to get notifications about new recipes. Also, don't forget to leave a comment. It will really encourage me to keep exploring, learning and improving my recipes. Let's check the ingredients now to make super delicious and protein-rich arbi ke patte for your family and friends. Hello friends, today we are cooking arbi ke patte. It is known by various names in various places. For example, in English it is called colocasia leaves or taro root leaves. In India it is called by different names in different regions like alu vadi, arbi patra, patrod, etc. If you like today's recipe, then please subscribe to Big Foodies and like and share this video. To make arbi ke patte, we have taken fresh and green arbi ke patte, colocasia leaves. Make sure to take green and fresh arbi ke patte. Also, you need to wash and towel dry arbi ke patte before using them in this recipe. To prepare arbi ke patte for this recipe, make sure it doesn't contain the stem on the back. If it is containing any part of the stem, then you can remove it. While cutting the stem, make sure to cut it at the edge only, not with the leaves. Otherwise, it can create a hole in the leaves, which we don't want for this recipe. Also, while buying arbi ke patte or colocasia leaves, try to buy the ones which are small or medium, not very big sized. Small sized leaves always taste better than the bigger ones, because small or medium leaves are tender with thinner veins at the back, while bigger ones are ripe and they have thicker veins at the back. Ripe leaves may have lot of fiber and may not yield the same taste. Also, if you find any visible stems at the back, ensure to slice it before using in the recipe. Removing this would help you to roll and shape the leaves with stuffing. You can see that the leaves we have taken are tender and fresh. Traditionally, besan and rice flour is used to make arbi ke patte. However, today we are making high protein arbi ke patte using lentils or dal. Trust me friends, you should try this recipe, you will love it. And after this, you will start making arbi ke patte using lentils instead of besan or rice flour. You can also call it as protein packed arbi ke patte ki sabzi. Some arbi leaves creates itching in the throat after eating. By preparing arbi leaves in this way, arbi ke patte don't create itching in the throat. To make our protein packed colocasia leaves or arbi leaves, we have taken here two types of lentils or dals. So here we are taking 1 cup of chana dal or split gram lentil and 1 cup of moong dal or split moong lentil. You can also take split moong lentil with skin here instead of the one we are using here, which is without its green skin. That will also give an amazing taste and flavor in this dish. You can decide the quantity of dal or lentil as per the quantity of arbi ke patte you want to make. Here we have taken this quantity for 10 to 12 medium sized colocasia leaves or arbi leaves. Just make sure the quantity of chana and moong dal are equal. Now we need to wash these lentils thoroughly with cold water to remove any impurities. So we have washed our lentils and now we will soak them in cold water for 4 to 5 hours. After soaking the lentils in cold water, now they are ready for the next step. Now give it a wash 1 to 2 times with water and then we will blend it. After washing it, we have transferred the lentils for grinding in a food processor. We can also use the grinder or blender to do the same job. Just make sure you don't add too much water while grinding, because we need to make a thick paste out of it. We will only add 2 to 3 tablespoons of water. Now add 1/2 inch of ginger, add few green chilies as per your taste, add some asafoetida, it will give a nice flavor to arbi ke patte. Add 3 to 4 teaspoons of fennel seeds or sonf. Fennel seeds is a must in this recipe, it adds an amazing taste in this dish. add 1/2 teaspoon of carom seeds or ajwain. Now grind it to make a coarsely ground thick paste. If during the grinding process you feel that it is not grinding properly, then add a few more tablespoons of water. It will help in the grinding process. But make sure not to add too much water because we want a thick paste. Now our coarsely ground lentil paste for making arbi ke patte is ready, and now we can transfer it in a bowl. So we have transferred the coarsely ground lentil paste in a bowl, and you can see the consistency of the paste. This is how it should look like, and you can see that it doesn't contain too much of water in it. So make sure your lentil paste doesn't contain too much of water in it. Now add the salt as per your taste. Mix it well. While we start preparing the arabic leaves with lentil paste, on the side we can start heating one steamer with some water in it, so that by the time our arabi ke patte are prepared, the water in the steamer starts boiling. If you don't have a steamer, you can also use a simple broad pan with some steel strainer on top to do the same job. We need to bring this water to a boil, so cover the steamer with the lid on top so that the water gets heated properly. To prepare the arbi leaves, take one leaf of arbi. On the front side of the arbi leaf, we will apply the paste that we have prepared. You can apply the paste on the front or back of arbi leaf as per your choice. It doesn't make any difference. Apply a thick layer of paste evenly on the arbi leaf. Thick lentil paste layer really gives a wonderful taste after cooking. You can spread it with spoon or using your hands. However, you can decide the thickness of layer as per your taste. If you want to apply thin layer, that is also fine. While applying the paste, leave 1/4 inch empty on all the sides of the leaf, as when we will fold the leaf, the paste will spread. The colocasia leaves has itchy characteristics and may itch your throat a little. Hence, a concentrated lentil paste should help to reduce its itchy behavior. Once you apply lentil paste evenly, fold it gently to form a roll. Don't press it while folding, otherwise paste can come out. Let me show you one more time. Take arbi leaf and start applying thick layer of lentil paste. Spread it evenly on the leaf and smooth it out with the spoon. If applying thick layer is making it difficult for you to roll the leaves, then apply a thin layer and make a roll. Fold it gently to form a roll. Like this, we will prepare all the arbi leaves. After applying the paste, all the arbi leaves are ready, and now we need to steam them in the steamer. Now the water in the steamer also started boiling. Now reduce the flame to medium low and start putting the prepared arbi leaves. Put them gently and make sure that the folded side goes on the bottom so that they stay packed and do not unfold while on the steamer. If prepared arbi leaves are leaking any water out of the lentil paste, it is fine. We don't need to worry about that. After putting all the arbi leaves, cover the steamer with the lid and put the flame to medium high. We need to steam the arbi leaves for about 15 to 20 minutes on a medium high flame. Now we are checking it after 15 minutes to check if arbi leaves are properly cooked or not. We need to poke a knife in the middle of one arbi leaf. If the knife comes out clean without any lentil paste sticking on it, that means arbi leaves are cooked nicely from inside out. If after inserting the knife you see some lentil paste on the knife, then steam arbi leaves for 5 more minutes and then it should be cooked nicely. Our knife is looking clean, that means our arbi leaves are cooked nicely. Let's do the same taste with one more arbi leaf. If that is cooked too, that means all the leaves are nicely cooked and we can take them all out of the steamer. Similarly, we can steam all the leftover arbi leaves if you have more. Now take out steamed arbi leaves with the help of a tong. After taking out the steamed arbi leaves, allow them to cool down. Now arbi leaves are cooled down, so we will cut them in small pieces. You can choose to cut the steamed arbi leaves as per your choice in thin or thick slices. So we will cut them in small slices. So you can see that our arbi leaves are steamed very well along with the lentils paste and looks delicious. Similarly, we can chop all the arbi leaves. Some people like to enjoy this steamed arbi leaves in this form only without frying them or making any tempering or tadka for them. You can enjoy them steamed with any kind of sauce or chutney of your choice. They taste super delicious. The steamed arbi leaves are the favorite for the kids. They love it. But in our case, we love our steamed arbi leaves coated in the tempering or tadka. So we will cook them in that way. Now we have chopped all the steamed arbi leaves. So we will prepare the tempering or tadka for steamed arbi leaves. While making the tempering or tadka for arbi leaves, you can adjust the quantity of oil and spices as per the quantity of arbi leaves you are making and also as per your taste. So for making the tempering, we have taken generous amount of oil in a broad pan kept on a medium flame. It is about 6 to 7 tablespoons of oil. Now add a pinch of asafoetida once the oil is hot. Add 2 teaspoons of cumin seeds or jeera. Add about 3 to 4 teaspoons of mustard seeds or rye. Mustard seeds really adds a nice flavor in arbi leaves. Allow the mustard and cumin seeds to crackle. Once mustard and cumin seeds crackle, add about 2 teaspoons of sesame seeds or dill. Sesame seeds really gives a nice flavor and taste to tempered arbi leaves. Roast for a minute and then add steamed arbi leaves. Now add the salt as per your taste. Remember, we have already added some salt while making lentils paste. So here we need to adjust the salt accordingly. Add 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder or haldi. Add the red chili powder as per your taste. Add a generous amount of coriander powder or dhania powder. We are adding about 4 to 5 teaspoons of coriander powder here. Add 1 teaspoon of garam masala powder. Now mix it well so that all the spices are mixed nicely with arbi leaves. Arbi leaves may break while mixing, so we have to mix them gently and carefully. After mixing, cover it with a lid and cook it on a medium-low flame for 10 to 15 minutes by stirring it occasionally in between. Make sure you cook it nicely so that the flavors of spices blends well with arbi leaves. So we have been cooking arbi leaves for about 15 to 20 minutes on a medium-low flame while stirring occasionally in between. Just give it a stir and now arbi leaves are ready and we can serve it. So friends, we have served arbi leaves with some coriander mint chutney. The recipe for coriander mint chutney you can find in my other video. You can enjoy these arbi leaves with any kind of sauce or chutney of your choice, or you can also serve them as a side dish. You can serve these arbi leaves or colocasia leaves either as a breakfast or snack. You can also enjoy them during lunch or dinner with roti, paratha, puri or rice. They taste really super delicious. Enjoy it with your family and friends. Friends, if you like this recipe, then please hit the subscribe button to subscribe Big Foodies for many more delicious recipes, and it is completely free. And hit the bell icon to get the notifications about new recipes. And don't forget to like and share this video. Also, don't forget to leave a comment. It will really encourage me to keep exploring, learning and improving my recipes. Friends, if you want to watch Big Foodies recipes in Hindi, then please visit and subscribe to Big Foodies Hindi channel for recipes in Hindi language. The link is given here. Thank you so much for watching.